us to have freedom. It's amazing. You ever walked around maybe before with a heavy pair of boots on or something, a big heavy backpack, and you've carried it so long that you kind of get used to the weight of it, and all of a sudden you take it off and you feel like you could run a marathon. You're like, wow, I didn't realize how heavy that was. You know, that's the way sin is. Sin's a heavy weight that we carry around. It's a bondage. But when the Lord removes those chains, there's freedom in knowing Christ. Can you say praise the Lord this morning?
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the eye I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. I just love the grace, unending love, amazing grace. The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secure. He will my shield and portion be, as long as life endures. My chains are gone, my God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like the flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. The earth shall soon be salt like snow. The sun for them to shine. The God who called me here below will be forever mine. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my
sing this morning before Brother Smith comes to preach to us. Amen. Young folks, come on around and sing for us this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
so much more. Go ahead, Sister Kathy. Throughout this service, one word just continued to run through my mind. Sometimes I have to pay real close attention to what the Lord's saying or showing me. Sometimes it's for me. Sometimes it's for those around me. Sometimes it's for something up in the near future. But the Lord shows me little things. I was joking around with some people here a while back because they say that every time you turn around, I said, well, there's a message in that. There's a message in that. People all the time tease me because I say that all the time. I said, when you preach, and you got to preach all the time, you got to find a message in something. And it's just the way it goes. But, you know, I was going throughout the service this morning. This one word has continually been on my mind, and that is expectation. And I'd like to ask us a question. I'd like to ask you a question. What did you come expecting today? Those of you that need to be baptized in the Holy Ghost, did you come expecting to receive it? Those of you battling with sickness, did you expect to come and maybe receive your healing? Battling with discouragement, expect to be revived anew? Did you come expecting just another ordinary service? How many would agree with me? We need to raise the bar of expectation. You know why I say that? Because the God that we serve is a mighty God. You say amen? Amen. He's not crippled. He's not feeble. He's not unable. He's not ill-equipped. He's very well capable. So why would we not come expecting? That'd be like that one person in your family that should have been named Betty Crocker from birth, and you showing up to their house and not expecting the food to be good. Come on now. How many says, God, help me to expect a mighty breakthrough and a move of God? I expect great things because I'm serving a great big God. Take that for what it's worth. I don't know what the Lord's about to share with us. I don't know what He's going to say. I trust that Pastor Smith knows God's talked to his heart. He's laid it upon him, spoke to him, and I do continue to ask you to be in prayer for me over the next couple of days that God will speak into my spirit and use me in a great and a mighty way. Last time we went off, preached a revival, one of the ladies that was there had been seeking the baptism of the Holy Ghost, received the Holy Ghost. And I want you to understand that is no stars and stripes on me or my wife. But I say that to tell you, God can use you if you put yourself in a position to be used. And that's just how good God is. I'd love to see God do that again, and even the more so this time. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Now give Brother Smith a hand and let him